What's the best method to arrange oranges to fill a box in as compact a way as possible? Placing them carefully in ordered rows or tossing them in at random? This is known as the sphere packing problem.
I give you a bunch of balls and you say, okay, how many balls can you put in this box?
How many of them can we fit in without actually letting them overlap or distorting them?
Sphere packing can serve as a sort of basic model of the structure of matter.
Three-dimensional spheres can represent atoms. An ordered packing might model a crystal or other solids, whereas disordered arrangements can represent liquids or gases.
A sort of way of probing the phases of matter.
In the late 16th century, British explorer Sir Walter Raleigh asked the mathematician Thomas Harriot to calculate the optimal way to stack cannonballs on the deck of a ship. Harriot later shared the problem with the astronomer Johannes Kepler. In 1611, Kepler hypothesized that the optimal three-dimensional packing would be a pyramid shape. Any sphere in the interior would touch 12 others, and the spheres would occupy about 74.05% of the available space. This became known as the Kepler conjecture.
It was actually a really long-standing open question in math to prove that that's the best way to do things in 3D. It took about 400 years.
To extend the problem from 3D spheres into higher dimensions, more coordinates can be added.
This defines some point inside of a box.
The sphere packing problem in higher dimensions has a range of applications, including in error correcting codes used in computer science. And now, an international group of young mathematicians have made a major advance on the sphere packing problem with a new proof.
One that works in all dimensions.